In response to viewers' requests, Echoing Praise presents Window to the Word. Unique.
God has a way of bursting out of our box, and what we see is, you know, cut and dried, this is the end of the rope. God says, no, there's more.
Fun.
God has used many people who thought they were zeros and turned them into heroes. When we are down to nothing,
God is up to something.
And totally inspiring. Join the twins sharing God's word and divine truths.
It's not about religion. It's about relationship.
One hand was clasped tightly over my eyes, and the other arm was flailing around in the dark, and I was saying, I just don't know the way. How do you forgive? He takes our flailing arm in his and says, but I do. And then he leads the way.
And the opening of the prison to the bound. Now, if you trace that phrase, opening of the prison, to its Hebrew roots, it means the opening of eyes.
Take a journey with us to discover what is behind the door.
And in the Bible days, the singers and the musicians and the dancers, they went first into the battle. And that's an amazing thing, because we think we gotta get our soldiers, we gotta send them out to the front lines. But in God's army, the worshipers go first. Mm-hmm. Why? Because that brings God's presence. And we want God on our front lines.
Yes. Did you know that Moses was 80 and Aaron was 83 in Exodus 7:7 when God sent them to free 2 million Hebrew slaves from Pharaoh?
Sometimes we just have to do something until the breakthrough happens. And not give up. Wait a minute. That's what you did. Huh? True confessions. But it actually wasn't your fault.
True confessions. Do you have a plan B? The option you do when you don't like what God says to do?
Psalm says that God inhabits our praises. When we invite a guest into our home, the first thing we do is offer them a place to sit. As we praise, we're inviting him to sit and stay with us, to be in our presence for a while. And so we brought this as a physical illustration to show how our praise is an invitation for God to come and abide with us. Did you know there are 7 Hebrew words which are translated in our Bibles generically as praise or worship? But actually in Hebrew, they each describe a specific action of praise to God.
I can identify with Ananias. You want me to do what, Lord? Lord, is this a good idea? If he called me to it, he'll get me through it.
The Sea of Galilee accepts the beautiful waters of the Jordan. It allows the waters to pass through, unlike the Dead Sea. Like Galilee, we have to share our gifts. It's what we do with those blessings that enables us to become an oasis, or it causes us to be stagnating without God's love flowing through us. And God said, mighty man of valor, and Gideon's like, who, me, Lord, me?
I know sometimes we think we're waiting on God, when really God is waiting on us.
Yes. And that's how the walls fall in our life. We offer our Zamar praise with instruments. He calls us the walls that crumble in our lives. Amen.
So we dare you to live a life of radical obedience and faith to God and God alone.
Yes.
Let's pray.
Join twins Misty and Christy on their new channel, Window to the Word, for a fun and totally inspiring look at the living Word of God. See you there.